Hello, project managers. Today I'm going to show you how you can easily manage complex projects across both Wrike and JIRA. By the end of this video, you'll know how to integrate JIRA with Wrike, identify flow direction, create rules, and map fields. And depending on your experience with Wrike, you might already have step one done. If you stick with me and follow the step-by-step guide, you'll be able to efficiently run multiple workflows across both platforms, making project management stress-free. So what's the first thing that you need to do? Well, it's to turn on Wrike Sync. If you purchase the Wrike Sync add-on from Wrike, then it's automatically enabled to your account. You don't need to do anything else. Go ahead and skip to this timestamp in the video if you've done so. But if you haven't, you can activate it manually by following these steps. Click your profile image in the upper left corner of your workspace. Select Settings from the dropdown, then click Subscription in the left panel. Scroll through the page until you find the Project Syncs add-on. Click the Add to Trial button. So you might notice something a bit different here, and that's because I've already gone through the process to make sure that everything works, which means I've already added Project Syncs, which is totally fine, don't worry about it. So in your case, what you're gonna see is that Project Syncs would be below add-ons available. And just like with Wrike Integrate and Wrike Lock, you'll have this Request Trial button. Go ahead and hit that for Project Syncs. A pop-up will appear at the top of the window to show that the Wrike Sync trial is activated. Click Go to Settings on the pop-up. Or if you accidentally clicked out of it like I did, click your profile image now in the top right corner, select Apps and Integrations, and click the Wrike Sync tab to open the settings. If there are multiple Wrike accounts associated with your email, select the relevant one. Then click the Authorize Wrike button to provide the sync tool access to your Wrike account. Hit Accept when it appears. With Wrike Sync on, we can finally connect the two apps. In the Wrike Sync tab, click Start here within the Connect Your Tools bar and choose the apps you want to connect. I'm picking JIRA Cloud for this example. Connect your account by pasting your account's URL and then select OAuth 2.0. Review the access permissions and then click Accept. Once done, hit Got It. After all that, we finally make it back to the Connect Your Tools screen. Complete it by clicking the drop-downs and selecting your account and your chosen project. For me, that's Integrate JIRA with Wrike. You might also see Wrike and JIRA automatically populate the types Task and Issue. Don't worry about those right now. We'll get to them later. Finally, hit Confirm. Now that we've connected the apps, we need to determine what kind of flow we want. Your flow defines where tasks will be created and how each platform will communicate information. You can choose between one-way sync or two-way sync. In a one-way sync, tasks created in one app will be transferred automatically to the second app, but tasks created in the second app will not appear in the first one. A two-way sync allows for tasks to be shared between apps regardless of where they were initially built. For this tutorial, I'm going to choose the one-way sync from Wrike to JIRA. Once you choose your flow, hit Confirm. That's all you need to do technically to connect Wrike and JIRA, but if you want them to communicate effectively with each other, you'll need to create some rules. Do this by filling in the criteria for your if-then workflow, and you can add as many criteria as you like in both the if and then sections. You can also add as many workflows as needed. For my example, I'm just going to add the rules set default assignee to myself and set default issue status to do. So when a task is made in Wrike, those two defaults should appear in JIRA when the task is reflected. Quick pro tip, when setting these rules, make sure the people creating the task in Wrike or JIRA are aware of what criteria are needed to fulfill the rules. Even if one detail is missed, that info won't be shared between the software, so be careful. Once you've finished building a rule, hit Confirm. After that, a pop-up will appear asking how you want to handle map fields. Okay, it's time to circle back to when Wrike populated the type as task while JIRA used issues. So the funny thing about JIRA is that it uses IT jargon for its project management software. So a task in Wrike is an issue in JIRA, but they're the same thing regardless. However, the back-end programming doesn't understand this. That's where mapping fields come in to help the software communicate with each other. Some fields are the same across both platforms, like assignees, subtasks, comments, and more, If your rules include any of those, then select Map automatically and let Unito handle it for you. But if your rules include specific jargon, such as importance versus priority or milestone versus epic, then click Map manually. If you do this, make sure you select the correct flow of information between the two platforms, or you can end up with some funny information that you'll see me have down the line. And now all my tasks here in Wrike are in JIRA, just like that. Now, the names are a little funny just because when I did the mapping manually example, I didn't properly set them perfectly. If I go back and do it automatically, these would be much more better adjusted. Or if I went and did it manually, then I would be more focused on making sure I select the correct ones in order to avoid this problem. Once you have everything mapped out as you need it, you're practically done. Last thing you need to do is step 5, which is launch your flow. You want to do that by going ahead and hit continue. A pop-up will appear asking if you're ready to launch your flow. You're going to hit launch flow if you're good. And that's it. Your Wrike and JIRA accounts are integrated and able to communicate with each other easily. If you don't currently have Wrike or JIRA software but want to try them out, then head to the description to find links to each. Or if you found this video difficult to follow, that's okay. We wrote down all these steps and posted them on project-management.com for your convenience. But before you go, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons while you're here. Helps me know that you enjoyed the video. Good luck and happy project managing.